hardest list ever to make. I just realized how many YouTube channels I watch on a daily basis. Wow. Hello and welcome to Coop Scoop Daily, the daily quest for facial hair. Today this is a video I've wanted to do for a long time. These are my top 10 favorite YouTubers. These are YouTubers that I watch religiously. Each time they upload a video, I can't resist but to press play because I love these channels so much. A few things, I didn't include figure reviewers, toy reviewers and stuff on this list because those are for a specific audience. And plus, like Sean Long, Shardos Prime, Glenn Webb, those kind of people. A few of those are actually like personal friends of mine, so I'd feel a little bit biased to put them in this list. And plus, I want to put things that put YouTube channels that anyone can get a kick out of, because you can't really get them. Not everyone's a collector. Not everyone can get impressed by a Marvel Legends figure review. So those are for a very specific audience that I happen to love, don't get me wrong, but not everyone's going to be entertained by those videos. And I know that personally because I'm a figure reviewer myself. So another thing too, I can't include video clips of these YouTubers because for copyright reasons, because I always get copyright strikes every time I put someone else's clips on my videos, because usually if they're like partners with Maker Studio or something, even if I include like a little like in thing in the description saying all rights go to them, it doesn't really work out so well. And also, not to mention, I can't do it anyway because I'm using my iPhone for this video and I can't include that kind of stuff through my iPhone because I don't have a PC, if you didn't know that, or Mac. There's also a few honorable mentions I want to mention just real fast. So going to do this really rapidly. These are the honorable mentions because there's so many channels I want to put on this list, but these guys I really want to fit in, but it's not going to, I can't do like a top 20 list because that's way too long. But so anyway, here we go. Honorable mentions. Philip DeFranco, awesome YouTuber. He talks about newsy type stuff and things that matter to him. It's how I know about most current events going on in the world. John Oliver, hilarious guy. He has his own show on HBO. He just uploads the funniest stuff about current events going on in the world and what needs to be focused on and changed in the world. Game Theory, obviously Game Theory. I'm sure you've watched Game Theory because that's like one of the most popular channels on YouTube. TV Maxwell. Okay, TV Maxwell, go check this guy out. Go just search in the YouTube bar, TV Maxwell. He makes the funniest sketches. Click on any of them. You're going to get a kick out of it. This guy needs some more love because this guy should have thousands of subscribers. And as well, I'm going to say, Good Mythical Morning. Good Mythical Morning, I watch every morning. Really kickstarts my day with Red and Link. So, all right, without further ado, let's get on with this list.
Number 11, Nostalgia Critic.
Wait a second. Top 11? This is a top 10 list. Oh, I get it, because this one's a Nostalgia Critic, and he does top 11 lists because he likes to go one step beyond. But yeah, this is one of my favorite YouTubers ever. He's not really even a YouTuber. He has his own website. He was That Guy with the Glasses, but now it's Channel Awesome. Anyway, he's just freaking amazing guy. He reviews all the things from your childhood. Look him up. He has so many reviews. He's been doing this for years and years and years, pretty much as long as Angry Video Game Nerd, which I want to include in this spot as well, but Nostalgia Critic I personally like better than Angry Video Game Nerd, but just by a smidge, because I love Angry Video Game Nerd as well. But yeah, I've always get a kick out of Nostalgia Critic videos. I've gone hours and hours and hours just watching his videos. My personal favorite review of him is, which one? I like the animated Titanic one, but there's just so many. There's so many good reviews that he does. So I'm sure, go kick back, watch him. He's absolutely hilarious, and plus he'll also bring a huge load of nostalgia in your face because of the movies and TV shows he reviews. So he's one of my favorites. So go, please go check him out.
Number 10, Mental Floss on YouTube.
Mental Floss on YouTube. Mental Floss is a magazine, but this is their YouTube version of the show. We usually with John Green. He's a hilarious guy, and they do like facts. Like they do like 22 facts about something. 22 facts about why chocolate's good, or like top 50 Disney facts, stuff like that. It's they're a fact channel, but they do it so well, and you actually see the guys do this video. So it's instead of like just pictures on the screen and you hear a voiceover. No, you see the guys talking about this, and plus their background is fun to watch because they have like so many little action figures and trinkets and stuff. And it's just, it's awesome, just brain feel. You watch it and you leave knowing something more that you didn't know before. So I love that show. Mental Floss is a great YouTube channel.
Number 9, Kid Icarus.
Ah, Kid Icarus. I love Kid Icarus. There's not going to be too many like video game reviewers on this top 10 because I love video game reviewers. I love Peanut Butter Gamer, JonTron, all those kind of people. But Kid Icarus happens to be my personal favorite because he just brings a certain like feeling. He also loves the PlayStation. I was a PlayStation kid growing up, and he also loves Evil Dead, and I just really relate to this guy a lot more, personally myself. And he's also British, which I love his accent. He's awesome, dude. And he just has a certain sense of humor that I don't really see in a lot of other YouTubers. Just it's kind of hard to explain that kind of sense of humor, but he's my personal favorite. I watch him all the time. One of my favorite reviews he's done was the one he was doing a review on this, oh gosh, the worst video game of all time, which is like really, it's like a video of these animals. It's not even a video game. It's just like you popped it in. It was like a video of like these talking animals. It's just so funny. And he just reviews it. I'm sorry. I'm going off. But seriously, go check him out. I wish I could remember the name of that video. But yeah, you'll find it. Once you see it, you'll know what I'm talking about. It's freaking hilarious.
Number 8, Vanoss Gaming.
Vanoss Gaming with H2O Delirious and all that. Oh my gosh. So funny. I'm not really all into like Let's Players and stuff, which he's not really a Let's Player, but just he just has so much fun with his friends, just going around on GTA Online and Gmod and stuff. It's so funny. This is like TV show stuff funny right here. Like this guy should have his own TV show, like Red versus Blue. He should have like his own TV show on like TV or something with these characters, because each of these characters, which are just players, but they have like such a certain, it seems like it's almost written, like he wrote a script for all these things that they're doing in GTA Online and stuff. But no, these are just all the top of the head, their heads, and gosh, it's just so entertaining to watch. Really, really is. I Am Wildcat, he's so funny. These are all people on the Vanoss Gaming channel that he plays with, so go check him out. You'll have your gut will explode of laughter.
Number 7, Ashens.
Stuart Ashens with a YouTube channel called Ashens. I know I was cheating a bit when I said I wasn't going to review figure reviewers, but this guy is more than a figure reviewer. He reviews everything from just like food, old food, weird international dishes and stuff. And he doesn't really even show his face. He just does it all on his couch. And he reviews just the worst things, knockoffs, dollar store stuff. And he just makes it so funny. It's just so interesting to see all these items that he finds. And he's also a comedian, so he has a few things to say about all these things that he finds and tastes and stuff. And it's absolutely hilarious. I can't stop watching his videos. He also reviews like knockoff electronics and video game hardware. So there's so many things to like about this channel, so go check him out.
Number 6, Cooking with Jack Show.
Cooking with Jack Show with Jack Scalfani. It's kind of weird to have a cooking show on this list, because I'm just a 19-year-old kid who's like obsessed with superheroes and stuff and video games, but there's Cooking with Jack Show is actually one that I watch all the time. Why? Because I like knowing how to cook things, because here I am growing up and I'm going to be moving out soon, and I want to be able to cook all these dishes without having to go to like McDonald's every night or eating ramen every night. But he like makes it so fun because he's not a chef. He's just a regular guy showing off these recipes and cool things like that and product reviews. So these are really helpful tips for me, knowing how to cook these dishes like ribs and cakes and whatnot, because I never really grew up cooking really, but I found myself to watching a lot of Cooking with Jack's show because he's just an entertaining cooking show on YouTube. So especially since this guy, he's just a regular guy, and he's kind of funny. Even he screws up a few dishes every now and again. It's just kind of funny to watch that. So if you're ever wanting to learn how to cook like awesome dishes and stuff, and you're like growing up, like you're a growing guy like me who's moving out and doesn't know many recipes, go watch him. You'll learn a lot.
Number 5, Live Fast, Die Poor, Random Land.
Live Fast, Die Poor, aka Random Land, with Justin Scard. Now, if you don't know me, this is also something I don't think I mentioned on my other fandoms I love list, but I am not ashamed to admit it, I'm a huge Disney nerd. I've always grown up with Disney. I watch it all, I've seen all the films, and as a musical theater actor, I'd always audition with Disney songs and stuff whenever I can, and I've always just loved Disney. I actually have like a bunch of Disney movies on my rack over here of movies. But anyway, yeah, he basically does Disneyland stuff, which also I'm a Disneyland geek. That's like the biggest part right there. I love Disneyland. I love all the facts and stuff. I've just grown up at Disneyland. I have like some of the best childhood memories there. And the last time I was there was 2012, and it was still awesome. I went with Austin. And what he does is he does a lot of Disneyland facts, showing off weird things inside the park. And not only that, he also goes to like filming locations and other places around California that are just like weird. And because he also did like a Star Wars filming locations video where he went out to Death Valley and shot a video of some of the filming locations and stuff. And not to mention, he's totally funny guy. So Live Fast, Die Poor. He also has a vlogging channel, which is Justin Scard. But yeah, go check them out if you're into like filming locations, Disney stuff. Because this guy's just so awesome.
Number 4, Adam the Woo.
Number 4 goes along with Live Fast, Die Poor is Adam the Woo. I've talked about Adam the Woo so many times in this channel. In fact, he's one of my inspirations for this vlog because he does his own daily vlog as well. But Adam the Woo, the main channel, so awesome. He does pretty much what Live Fast, Die Poor does with Justin Scard. He's actually partners with them too. Him and Justin Scard are really good friends with each other. They always make videos with each other. But Adam the Woo does like abandoned fun places. Like he goes to abandoned theme parks, and it's just so interesting to watch this kind of stuff. Abandoned houses, hotels, also as well as filming locations, because he has this awesome Back to the Future filming location video. So awesome. And there's just a ton more that he does. I cannot stop watching this guy. So that was weird. I just noticed a door cracked open. My cat just came in. Hi, cat. But yeah, Adam the Woo, even his daily channel is awesome because he pretty much does the same stuff he does on his main channel, but with his daily show, it's unedited, and he just visits all sorts of locations, and he travels around the country too. I want to do that so bad, just travel around the country and look at all these different things. Adam the Woo knows how to live life. So please, if you ever want to get like a dose of what's going on in the like travels and stuff, Adam the Woo is the guy for you. So awesome, man. Like I said, he's an inspiration for me, so please go show him some Coop Scoop Daily love.
Number 3, Filthy... What the hell?
Yeah, Filthy Frank. If you don't know Filthy Frank, you might not like Filthy Frank, because if you watch Filthy Frank, you already know what Filthy Frank is like. There's not much I can explain there. But Filthy Frank, I think, is a genius. Freaking funny stuff. I'm just going to say this now. If you're easily offended by anything on the internet, don't go watch Filthy Frank. But there's not much I can say about Filthy Frank.
Hey, boss.
Number 2, AMC Movie Talk.
AMC Movie Talk. I love these guys. These guys are so fun to watch. It's how I personally know about a lot of things going on in Hollywood and upcoming films and stuff. And I like hearing these guys' input, although a lot of the time I disagree with what they have to say, like The Amazing Spider-Man 2, for example, because John Schnapp hated that movie. But anyway, I've met John Schnapp. I have signature on the wall with the whole team on the picture. It's like right over here. I wish I could turn my camera around right now, but it would screw everything up right now. But like, I watch these guys. It's how I know a lot about a lot of things going on in Hollywood, upcoming films and stuff. It's just really entertaining to watch these guys, and They're also true nerds too. Like they have their. I watch these shows mostly like AMC Heroes with John Schnepp and Jedi Council with Christian Harloff. These guys, just they know their stuff, and I learn more every time I watch them. So, awesome stuff. If you're a huge movie fan, go check them out.
And finally, number one, Jack's Films, bitches.
Number one on this list, Jack's Films. Oh my gosh, I watch this guy all the time. Each time I watch him, I just end up laughing. He's so funny with all his videos. I have yet to watch a video of his where I didn't at least chuckle. They're all so good. He posts videos on a daily basis. And he's my absolute favorite YouTuber. Everything from Your Grammar Sucks, Yai, Jackass. He has just the funniest views on how the internet works and people. And he's absolutely freaking hilarious. I can't explain it. Go watch him. Why are you watching me? Go watch Jack's Films. Go watch him. Do it now. Do it now. Anyway, you guys, thank you so much for watching. Also, all the links are in the description of all the YouTubers I just mentioned besides the honorable mentions. You guys have to go search those yourselves. I'm sorry I couldn't fit those all in here. But yeah, all the other YouTubers down there in the description, please go check out these channels. They're so awesome. I cannot explain to you how much I love these guys. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in tomorrow's vlog. Bye. Bye.